Hello guys, in this video lecture we are learning about circuit switching and packet switching. So basically, what are the concept of circuit switching and packet switching in the computer networks? Let's see here. Suppose this is a circuit switching in which there are several it is a network and several computer systems are added throughout that. And suppose this is a source computer, source device, and it is the destination device. Then to send message in circuit switching, basically it will first connection establishment will be there, right? So it will establish the connection throughout the proper channel. Once the connection is established, after that the data will be transferred, and after that the connection will be released, right? So connection termination will be there. So this is the concept of circuit switching. And in packet switching, what will happen, the data will be directly transferred to throughout the network, and they will find the path and ultimately send the data to the destination. So basically in packet switching, there is not any type of connection establishment and there isn't any connection release, right? There is direct data transfer. And in circuit switching, there are connection establishment, data transfer, and then connection release. Right now, let's see the differences between circuit switching, packet switching, the various concepts and the differences, and what are the procedure of that, right? So let's see about that. Circuit switching, each data have an entire path address, right? So basically in circuit switching, there is establishment of connection, then data transfer, and then termination, right? That's why each data have entire path address there. Whereas in packet switching, only destination address is there, right? Only destination address is there, because we have only transfer data and only destination address is have data in, means data in it here only have destination, right? Destination address. It is not a store and forward technique, right? Means data once gained, it will send throughout that path address. Whereas store and forward technique is applied here, the data is stored there, and after that the best path will be found throughout the best algorithm. After that the optimal algorithm, the optimal path will be found using the algorithm, and then the data unit will be sent. That is why it is a store and forward technique, whereas it is not a store and forward technique, right? Because here once the path address is there, we have to send continuously data throughout that path, right? Even though if there is best path, we have our necessity to send only throughout that path, right? In circuit switching. Now in circuit switching, resources are reserved here, right? Resource reservation is there because we are not using any resources, right? But resources are shared here. In packet switching, resources are shared here, right? That is why the wastage of resources here are less. Whereas resource reservation is there, that is why wastage of resources are very more in there, right? So this is the basic difference, and let's see some more differences between this. Transmission of data is done by source, because in circuit switching a path is existed there, right? That is why transmission of data is done by source. Whereas in packet switching, transmission of data is done by source as well as intermediate routers, because intermediate routers are as important as the source is there, because after sending from source, data unit is goes to the intermediate routers, and then they will find the optimal path and then they will send to the next router. That is why transmission of data is done by source as well as intermediate routers in packet switching. Delay between data unit is uniform throughout the path, because if we are sending the data unit throughout the path, the delay between data unit is constant here. Whereas delay between the data unit is variable, because it might take somewhat long into the other unit, whereas it might take somewhat less time to other data unit, because here path is not existed, right? So it depends on which path that data is transferred, right? And if you will see here, not a fault tolerant technique, right? So circuit switching is not a fault tolerant technique, whereas packet switching is a fault tolerant technique, because data can be diverted throughout the path, right? Because no path is existed here, but here path is existed, so data will be consistent into the path only, right? That is why it is not a fault tolerant technique. Now conjunction can occur during connection establishment, right? So at the time of connection establishment from the source to destination, there is maybe conjunction occur, right? That process when we connect to the several networks, right? So in connection, conjunction can occur. But here connection can be occur during data transfer, because to connect each and every other devices, then may be need of conjunction, right? So at the time of data transmission, conjunction can be occur, right? Now let's see some more important differences between them. Circuit switching, it uses synchronized TDM. TDM here is time division multiplexing, right? So it uses synchronized time division multiplexing, in which the data will be transmitted will be multiplexing means many to one, right? So many to one data will be happen according to time division multiplexing, right? So time will time frequency will be same here, right? But here asynchronous time division multiplexing is there in packet switching. It prefers long messages because data is data path is there. That is why once the because if short messages will be there, then throughput will be less, right? Because we have adjusted path. That is why it will prefer that long messages should come. That is why the throughput will be greater because it will be it should be busy. But if short messages should be there, then it will not be busy, right? Whereas in packet switching, it will prefer short messages because here path is not existed. That is why if short messages come, it will find fastly that which path is best, and according to that, it will go towards destination, right? So it prefers short messages. It is reliable because it is connection. You can see that it is one way of connection oriented like that because path is existed. That is why the loss of data is not there. Because that is why it is reliable because there is path existed. But it is called as unreliable because there isn't any path. You can't even though meanwhile you can't say that where is your data converted or diverted, right? That is why it is unreliable. It is slow process because if path is existed and it might take somewhat long path to receive or to send from source to destination, but it is fast method because it will always use the fastest algorithm or the optimal path through which we have sending data to source to destination, right? So these are the complete differences which we have discussed between circuit switching and packet switching. In our upcoming videos, we will see about more in computer networks and all the technical subjects, important updates, latest notification from your examination. So please don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel, and if you like our videos, please like us, and if you have any kind of doubts or queries, please comment us so that we will solve your doubt and queries as early as possible. Thank you so much guys. Have a nice day. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon. So you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video, you will get a notification on your phone.